Herkese merhaba. Dersimize hoş geldiniz. Bu dersimizde 7 İklim Türkçe A1 çalışma kitabımızın 15, 16 ve 17. sayfalarını işleyeceğiz. Hello everyone, welcome to our lesson. In this lesson, we will do the pages 15, 16 and 17 of our 7 İklim Turkish A1 workbook. On this page, we will do ordering activity. Sıralayalım means ordering. So, the first sentence is iyi günler. İyi günler means, as you can remember, have a good day. So, the second sentence is İyi günler. I will repeat it again. İyi günler. Okay, this is third. Nasılsınız? How are you? Please pay attention. This is formal situation. I also want to remind you that as an informal situation, we can ask like this. Nasılsın? This is informal situation. Teşekkür ederim. İyiyim. Siz nasılsınız? Teşekkür ederim. İyiyim. Siz nasılsınız? This is for. Thank you. I am good. How are you? The last sentence is teşekkür ederim. Ben de iyiyim. Thank you. I am good too. Okay, now I will read sentences again. İyi günler. İyi günler. Nasılsınız? Teşekkür ederim. İyiyim. Siz nasılsınız? Teşekkür ederim. Ben de iyiyim. So, we have completed this activity. Please also read these sentences yourself. On this page, we will do writing activity. Yazalım means writing. Now, we will write the numbers. Sayılar means numbers. Okay. 1 2 3 1 2 3 15 As you can remember, 10 means 10, 5 means 5, so 15, 15, 32, 32, 30 means 30, 2, you can also remember here, means 2, so 32, 32, 150, 100, 100, 50, 50, 150, 150. 13, 13, 10 means 3, 3 means, sorry, I made a mistake. 10 means 10, 3 means 3, 13, 13. 7, 7, 9, 9, 117, 100, 100, 10, 10, 7, 7. So, 117, 117. So, we have also completed this activity. Please check your answers. On this page, we will do completing activity. Tamamlayalım means completing. Güle güle. Güle güle means bye. İyi akşamlar. İyi akşamlar. Have a good evening. Hoşça kalın. Hoşça kalın. Goodbye. Kusura bakmayın. Kusura bakmayın. Sorry. Or excuse me. Müşteri. Müşteri. Client. Görevli. Görevli. Officer. So, we will write the sentences. İyi akşamlar. Have a good evening. İyi akşamlar. Buyurun. Have a good evening. Here you are. Or here you go. So, buyurun means here you are. Or we can translate like here you go. İyi akşamlar, buyurun. Boş odanız var mı? Boş odanız var mı? Do you have a vacancy? Do you have a vacancy? Maalesef, bütün odalar dolu. Maalesef, bütün odalar dolu. I will write the meaning of this here. Unfortunately, maalesef means unfortunately. Bütün odalar dolu. Bütün odalar dolu means no vacancy. I will read the sentence again. Maalesef bütün odalar dolu. Kusura bakmayın. So, we used iyi akşamlar and we used kusura bakmayın. Kusura bakmayın means sorry or excuse me. Maalesef bütün odalar dolu. Kusura bakmayın. Rica ederim. Rica ederim. You're welcome. Hoşça kalın. Rica ederim. Hoşça kalın. Hoşça kalın means goodbye. Güle güle. Güle güle. Güle güle means bye. So we have also completed this activity. You can also check your answers. On this page, we will also do writing activity. Yazalım means writing. Okay, the first one is 4, 4, 12. As you can remember, 10 means 10, 2 means 2. So 12 means 12. 35. 30 means 30. 5 means 5. 35. 35. 19. 10 means 10. 9 means 9. 19 means 19. 147. 100. 100. 40. 40. 7. 7. So 147 is 147. I will read it again. 147. 1,995. 1,000. 1,000. 900. 900. 90. 90. 5. 5. So 1,995 is 1,995. 1,995. 1,995. So we have also completed this activity. Now you can check your answers. On this page, we will do completing activity. Cevaplayalım means completing. Okay, the first one. Sınıfta kaç öğrenci var? Sınıfta kaç öğrenci var? How many students are there in class? I also want to write here. Sınıf means class. Sınıfta means in class. Sorry. In class. So, sınıfta kaç öğrenci var? How many students are there in class? As you know, öğrenci means student. Sınıfta öğrenci var. Okay, we will write here. Now we will look at. Bir, iki, üç, dört. Sınıfta dört öğrenci var. There are four students in class. This is öğretmen. Öğretmen means teacher. Okay, the second question. Resimde kaç kişi var? Resimde kaç kişi var? How many people are there in the picture? How many people are there in the picture? Bir, iki, üç, dört, beş. Resimde beş kişi var. There are five people in the picture. Please pay attention. Resim means picture. Resimde means in the picture. Resimde kaç ev var? Resimde kaç ev var? How many houses are there in the picture? Ev means house. We can answer like this. Resimde bir ev var. I also need to tell you that kaç means how many. Resimde kaç ev var? How many houses in the picture? Houses, ev. In the picture, resimde. So, var means, as you can remember, there is or there are. Actually, we can translate like this. How many houses are there in the picture? How many houses are there in the picture? So, the last question. Evde kaç oda var? How many rooms are there in the house? How many rooms are there in the house? So we can say birinci oda, ikinci oda, first room, second room. This is mutfak. Mutfak means kitchen. So we can say there are two rooms. Resimde iki oda var. There are two rooms in the picture. So, you can also check your answers. Please don't forget to take notes. On this page, we will also do a writing activity. Yazalım means writing. Adam, man, iki adam, two men, adamlar, men, şemsiye, umbrella. So we can do like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So this is 1. Okay, şemsiye, umbrella. 4 şemsiye. 4 umbrellas. Şemsiyeler. Umbrellas. Kuş. Kuş means bird. So this is 3. 3 kuş. 3 birds. Kuşlar. Birds. Yaprak means leaf. So this is yaprak. 5 yaprak. 5 leaves. Yapraklar. Leaves. Balık. Balık. Fish. So I will look at balık. Okay. 12 balık. 12 fishes. Balıklar. Fishes. Şapka. Şapka. Şapka means hat. So this is şapka. 6 şapka. 6 şapka. 6 hats. Şapkalar. Hats. Okay, the last one. Çanta. Çanta. Çanta means bag. So this is 7. 18 çanta. 18 çanta. As you can remember, 10 means 10. 8 means 8. 18, 18. 18 çanta means 18 bags. Çantalar means bags. So we have also completed this activity. Please check your answers and take notes of the new words. On this page, we will do a reading activity. Okuyalım means reading. Emlakçıda. Emlakçıda. At the real estate agent. At the real estate agent. Sorry, agent. Normally we can say emlakçı, real estate agent. But please pay attention. Emlakçıda means at the real estate agent. So please take note of this. Okay, now I will read it for you. I also need to tell you that birinci öğrenci means first student. As you can remember, birinci, first, ikinci, second, üçüncü, third, dördüncü, fourth, and it continue like this. Please, if you don't know this, watch the Yedi İklim Türkçe A1 dersleri playlist. Okay. Emlakçı. I also write here emlakçı. Real estate agent. İkinci öğrenci. Second student. Okay, now I can begin to read. İyi günler. İyi günler. Hoş geldiniz. Hoş bulduk. Kiralık ev var mı? Evet, var. Öğrenci misiniz? Evet, öğrenciyiz. Nerelisiniz? Ben Konyalıyım. Arkadaşım İzmirli. Memnun oldum. İşte size uygun bir ev. İki oda, bir salon. Evde eşya var mı? Evet, var. Kira ne kadar? 500 lira. Çok pahalı. Teşekkür ederiz. İyi günler. Hoşça kalın. Güle güle. So now I will read the meaning of these sentences for you. İyi günler. İyi günler means have a good day. İyi günler. Hoş geldiniz. Have a good day. Welcome. Hoş geldiniz means welcome. Hoş bulduk. Kiralık ev var mı? So, hoş bulduk means thank you. Kiralık ev var mı? Is there a house for rent? Is there a house for rent? Evet, var. Öğrenci misiniz? Evet, var. Means actually you can remember from our last lessons. Evet, var means yes, there is. Öğrenci misiniz? Are you students? Evet, öğrenciyiz. Yes, we are students. Nerelisiniz? Where are you from? Ben Konyalıyım. Arkadaşım İzmirli. I am from Konya. Arkadaşım means my friend. So, arkadaşım İzmirli means my friend. Is from İzmir. Memnun oldum. İşte size uygun bir ev. İki oda, bir salon. Memnun oldum. Pleased to meet you. İşte size uygun bir ev. Here is a house for you. İki oda, bir salon. Oda means room. Salon means living room. So, iki oda, bir salon. Two rooms and one living room. Two rooms and one living room. I also want to say that again. Salon means living room. Oda means room. Evde eşya var mı? Are there any items in the house? Evet, var. Yes, there is. So this is also a new word. Eşya means item, or we can also say furniture. Item or furniture means eşya. Please, if you don't know, take note. So, kira ne kadar? How much is the rent? How much is the rent? Kira means rent. Ne kadar means how much? 500 lira. 500 lira. 500 Turkish liras. Çok pahalı. Çok pahalı. We can say very expensive. Or too expensive. So çok means I will write here. Much, many, very, or too. Pahalı means expensive. I also want to write here. Ucuz means cheap. Okay, We can continue. Teşekkür ederiz. İyi günler. Okay, pay attention. Teşekkür ederiz. Not teşekkür ederim. There's a written here. Teşekkür ederiz. So the meaning of this. We thank you. İyi günler. Have a good day. Hoşça kalın. Goodbye. Güle güle. Güle güle means bye. So there are too many words on this page. If you don't know the meaning of them, please take note and try to study. On this page, we will do reading and writing the numbers activities. Okuyalım means, I hope that you know, reading. Sayıları yazalım. As you can remember, sayılar means numbers. Yazalım means writing. So, sayıları yazalım, writing the numbers. Emlakçıda, at the real estate agent. So, ikinci öğrenci, I also want to write there again. İkinci öğrenci means second student, emlakçı, real estate agent. Birinci öğrenci, first student. So I want to tell you that please try to do this dialogue with your friends, and so you can improve your pronunciation also. Okay, now I will read them for you, and then I will show you the meaning of the words. Bu ev kaç odalı? 3 oda, 1 salon. Küçük bir ev yok mu? Elbette var. İşte fotoğrafı. 2 oda, 1 salon. Kirası kaç lira? 400 lira. I will read them again. Bu ev kaç odalı? 3 oda, 1 salon. Küçük bir ev yok mu? Elbette var. İşte fotoğrafı. 2 oda, 1 salon. Kirası kaç lira? 400 lira. Bu ev kaç odalı? Means how many rooms does this house have? How many rooms does this house have? 3 oda, 1 salon. 3 oda means 3 rooms. 1 salon means 1 living room. Küçük bir ev yok mu? Küçük bir ev yok mu? Don't you have a small house? Don't you have a small house? Küçük bir ev yok mu? Elbette var. İşte fotoğrafı. 2 oda, 1 salon. Elbette var means of course there is. Of course there is. So please pay attention. This is new word. Elbette means of course. Elbette. İşte fotoğrafı. İşte fotoğrafı. Here is the photo. Here Is the photo. So, işte means here. İki oda, bir salon. İki oda, bir salon. So, please try to translate these sentences yourself. İki oda, bir salon. Two rooms, one living Kirası kaç lira? Kirası kaç lira? How much is the rent? How much is the rent? So, kira means rent. Kirası kaç lira? How much is the rent? 400 lira. 400 lira. 400 Turkish lirası. So, now we will write the numbers on the passages. Okay. Bu ev kaç odalı? 3 oda, 1 salon. So, 3 oda, 1 salon. 3, it is written here. 1 salon. 1 salon means one living room. Küçük bir ev yok mu? Elbette var. Sorry, I forget to write here. Küçük bir ev yok mu? Bir also is a number. So, bir. Elbette var. İşte fotoğrafı. İki oda, bir salon. İki means two, bir means one. So, iki, bir. Kirası kaç lira? How much is the rent? 400 lira. So, 400. Dört yüz. Okay. So please also check your answers. Now we can continue. I think this is our last exercise. Yes. On this page we will do completing activity. Tamamlayalım means completing. Kayıt bürosunda. Kayıt bürosunda. Kayıt bürosunda means at the registry office. So kayıt bürosu. This is a new word for you. Registry office. Kayıt bürosunda at, or we can also say in, at the registry office. Okay, now we will try to complete the sentences together. İyi günler. Burası kayıt bürosu mu? İyi günler. Have a good day. Burası kayıt bürosu mu? Burası kayıt bürosu mu? So the meaning of this: is this the registry office? Have a good day. Is this the registry office? Evet, burası kayıt bürosu. Hoş geldiniz. Yes, this is the registry office. Welcome. Yes, this is the registry office. Hoş geldiniz means welcome. Teşekkür ederim. Hoş bulduk. Teşekkür ederim means thank you. Hoş bulduk. We can also translate it like thank you, but I also want to write here, we are welcomed. So, you can check the answer, Sedat Mutlu. So, the question is related to the name or surname. We can ask like this: adınız nedir? What's your name? Sedat Mutlu. Please also pay attention. This is also a formal situation for asking the name in Turkish. Adınız nedir? What's your name? Yes, this is formal. Sedat Mutlu. Okay. So, you can also look at here. Ankaralıyım. We should ask where are you from? Nerelisiniz? Where are you from? Ankaralıyım. I am from Ankara. Okay, there is also a question here. So, the answer is 21 Aralık 1988. 21 Aralık 1988. So, this could be a birth date. We can also ask like this: doğum tarihiniz nedir? Doğum tarihiniz nedir? Okay, the meaning of this: what's your birth date? Yirmi bir Aralık 1988. Okay, 21 means 21. Aralık, December, and 1988. 1988. Okay, we can continue. İşlem tamam. İşlem tamam means process is done. So, işlem means process. This is also a new word. Please take note. Or as an English idiom, we can translate like this: the die has been cast. So, I will take here. İşlem tamam. The die has been cast. This is also English idiom. Okey. Teşekkür ederim. Hoşça kalın. Teşekkür ederim. Thank you. Hoşça kalın. Goodbye. Rica ederim. Güle güle. You're welcome. Bye. Rica ederim means you're welcome. Güle güle means bye. Okay. You can also check your answers. Our lesson is over. If you have any questions, you can write them in the comments section. See you in our next lesson.